Happy New Year. I'm glad you're joining with us today on New Year's. And today I'm going to be talking about a renewed year. Not a New Year's resolution, but a renewed year. And I want you to have a renewed year to hear what God wants to do in your life. But before we do that, just enter into worship before the Lord.
Come all you weary, come all you thirsty, come to the well that never runs dry. Drink of the water, come and thirst no more. Come all you sinners, come find his mercy, come to the table, he will satisfy. Taste of his goodness, find what you're looking for. For God so loved the world that he gave us, his one and only Son to save us. Whoever believes in him will live forever. Bring all your failures, bring your addictions, come lay them down at the foot of the cross. Jesus is waiting there with open arms. For God so loved the world that he gave us, his one and only Son to save us. Whoever believes in him will live forever. The power of hell forever defeated, now it is well. I'm walking in freedom, for God so loved the world. Praise God, praise God, from whom all blessings flow. Praise him, praise him, for the wonders of his love. Praise God, praise God, from whom all blessings flow. Praise him, for the wonders of his love.
His amazing love.
For God so loved the world that he gave us, his one and all, his Son to save us. For God so loved the world that he gave us, his one and only Son to save us. Whoever believes in him will live forever. The power of hell forever defeated, now it is well. I'm walking in freedom, for God so loved, God so loved the world. Bring all your failures, bring your addictions, come lay them down at the foot of the cross. Jesus is waiting, God so loved the world. I can't.
Lord Jesus.
song is forever yours. A thousand hallelujahs and a thousand more.
Thank you, worship team. You know, it's that time of year when we hear about New Year's resolutions. Many people proclaiming this or that, or they're going to do this, or they're going to, I mean, the one we hear all the time is, I'm going to lose weight, I'm going to work out, I'm going to start new gym membership. And there's so many things that people say, but they don't follow through. But today, I want us to look at something that God can do in us. You know, if we look at 1 Peter 1, 13 through 16, it gives us the perfect New Year's resolution. It says this, therefore prepare your mind for action, be self-controlled, set your hope fully on the grace to be given to you when the Lord Jesus Christ is revealed. As obedient children, do not conform to the evil desires you had when you lived in ignorance. But just as he who called you is holy, so be holy in all you do, for it is written, be holy because I am holy. Having renewed ears. That's what we're going to talk about today. We're going to talk about our ears, these two things. That's why God gave us one mouth and two ears, so we should listen twice as much. And I think it's important that we learn how to do that. Christians can experience the same kind of life that the Apostle Paul lived. Paul wrote this in Galatians 2:20. I, having been crucified with Christ, am no longer alive, but Christ lives in me. The life I live, the body, I live by faith in the Son of God, who loved me and gave himself for me. King David foreshadowed the time when future generations would be told about the Lord. When a time when people of God would proclaim his righteousness to the people yet unborn. The Apostle Peter wrote about the work of Christians in 1 Peter 2:9. It says this, but you are a chosen people, a royal priesthood, a holy nation, a people belonging to God, that you might declare the praises of him who called you out of darkness into his wonderful light. You know, the desire of the heart of Christians should be to have an undefiled ear. What is an undefiled ear? To not subject ourselves to things we shouldn't. Look at what Isaiah 54:5 says. The sovereign Lord has given me an instructed tongue to know the word that sustains the weary. He awakens me in the morning by morning, wakens my ear to listen like one being taught. The sovereign Lord has opened my ears, and I have not been rebellious. I have not drawn back. I like how the New American Standard says, he says to listen as a disciple. The Lord God has opened my ear. when we let our ears listen to the call of the flesh or the lies of the world, we get messed up. We have a hard time getting our spiritual ears tuned in if we're filling our head full of junk, if we're filling it with all these things that the world brings at us, all their stuff, what they believe, how they think things work. He who has the most toys wins. No. When we allow our heart and stuff to be filled with all those things, it messes us up. When we let Jesus Christ dwell in our hearts, He can wake up our spiritual ears and give us an attitude of listening. You know, they have ears of a learned disciple of Christ to listen. They have ears that not only hear the call of God, but understand it. I've heard so many people, well, I hear the scripture, I don't understand it, I don't take it. Well, spend time in it. I mean, all of us can fall into this mode of this spiritual sleepiness. And it needs to be awakened daily. We need to spend time in the Word daily. That should be the thing that transforms us. That should be the thing that we should meditate upon. It's God's commands and His precepts. We all have to make a daily choice. In the world, we make choices daily. In Luke 21, 37 and 38, we read that He taught us every day in the temple. The people got up every morning to hear Him teach. To have desire. To want to gather. To want to hear the Word of God. Christians have the Word of God, yet many times they don't even open it up and look at it. I mean, this is the easiest day and age that we could read the Scripture. There are apps that will read the Bible to you. And yet we don't listen to the Word of God. You know, we got to make a choice daily that we have a listening heart, that we have a desire to do that. We choose to listen and watch things that are good and bad every day. We make a choice every day to either be closer to God or be further away by whether we follow the rule of the flesh or the spirit. Who are you following? On the road to Emmaus, two disciples had their hearts burning within them as they talked with Jesus about the Holy Scripture, as they talked about the Bible. When He later appeared to His disciples in Luke 24:45, it says this, "Then He opened their minds so they could understand the Scriptures." You know, we got to ask God, open our minds up that we can understand what You're saying. It's the Holy Spirit that enlightened Christians whom God would use to get the message of Christ to others, to the world, to everyone around us. That's what He used. In the book of Nehemiah, we read of a time after Nehemiah had made adequate preparations to guard the city. And there, the walls are working on the walls. And he appointed singers so Jerusalem could have the joy of the Lord. And then he made provision for the great readings of the Word of God. The Bible says that on the first day of the seventh month, the people assembled as one man, and Ezra the priest read aloud from the law from daybreak till noon. Let me read that again. From daybreak to noon. The Bible says that the people listened attentively to the book of the law. And on the second day of the seventh month, the head of families, the priests, and the Levites gathered to give attention to the words of the law. There's something about listening to the Word of God, getting it in you. The Bible says that at the time, those who read from the law taught it in a way to make it clear, the teaching so the people could understand what was being proclaimed through the law of God. Before the month was over, there was a great revival among God's people. By the 24th day, the Israelites gathered, confessing their sins and the sins of their fathers. We read that people stood and they listened to the book of law for a quarter of the day. For a quarter of the day. Sometimes we need to take an intensive time to be with the Lord, to focus on Him, to hear. Christians who used to carry the gospel to the next generation, we need to be that. We need to be those people. You can't carry something you don't know. We need to be noble-minded people, a people giving generous attention and who have a great eagerness to receive the message and listen to it respectfully. They entered into the place of public worship to listen. Sometimes we need to have our heart ready to hear what God wants to speak to us, even as we come to church, or even as we take time to read our Bible in the morning, or in the evening, or at noontime, whenever you do. You need to be reading. They long to become disciples of Christ, and they imitate His life by being listeners of God. Ecclesiastes 5:1 says this, "Guard your steps when you go into the house of God. Go near to listen rather than offer a sacrifice of fools who do not know what they are doing." You're coming to God every time you come because you want God to work in your life. You want Him to change. You know, as we live in this world, people know the value of listening and those who don't. And it's plainly evident. People in the workplace become angry or frustrated, and they will gather in a group of people around who then will tell them what they want to hear. Family members become upset over something, and they will gather with other family members who will tell them what they want to hear. Someone who becomes offended in a relationship will get a hold of a friend and tell them what they want to hear. A listener is the type of person who will gather a proven group of people in a field of life around them and gain insight and wisdom on how to live, to do the work or develop their trade. They spend time with not necessarily the people that agree with them, but the people who will listen and give wisdom and instruction. Regarding our walk with the Lord, to have undefiled ears means that we have a heart to seek after God and a willingness to have a changed life. Do you really want change to happen? Let's look at Romans 12:1. It says this, "Therefore, I urge you, brothers, in view of God's mercy, to offer your bodies as living sacrifices, holy and pleasing to God. This is your spiritual act of worship. Do not conform any longer to the patterns of this world, but be transformed by the renewing of your mind. Then you'll be able to test and approve what God's will is, His good and pleasing and perfect will." Hearing from the Lord requires sacrifice. Just like anything that's worth doing, it requires a sacrifice of time, of effort, and money. Did you hear that? Christians need to sacrifice our time and our effort, and yes, even some of our money. You know, I've always heard, where your heart is, that's where your money is also. And so if you're having trouble with those things, you need to evaluate those things. You know, Christians need to make time to expose themselves to reading and teaching of God's Word. They need to spend time in God's Word. You know, sometimes you need to listen to some preaching. And it may not just be your preacher. It may be somebody who's solid in the Word outside your circle. You know, God uses people all around me. You know, God uses other preachers. I can hear the Word from anywhere. God can speak to me if I have ears to hear. You know, we also need to be make an effort to be critiqued by Jesus. We need to allow God to touch and change some things in our life. You know, you realize that you don't know the best way to do everything. You know, I was thinking about that. You know, we have a men's breakfast every month, and you know, somebody took me under their wing and taught me how to do things and taught me a better way to do things. I'd done things a certain way, making gravy a certain way. Somebody taught me a better way. And when I learned it, that was much better, much easier. No more lumps in my gravy. You know, we need to be able to learn like that in our own life, that we can allow people to touch us in such a way that we can be hearers. You know, God wants you to hear what He wants to do. You know, I think about this. You know, if I wanted to learn from a woodworking, I wouldn't go seek out the advice of the cook and the chef and the cookbook. I would seek the carpenter, the woodworker, to figure out things. I would read about how to do things to understand. And a lot of times we think that as Christians it's different. No, we need people who are following Christ to pour into our life. That's who we need to be asking. You don't go ask a sinner how to be a Christian. You go ask a Christian. And so many times we miss the point of what God wants to do as we just open up to Him. I'm believing for God to do a work in you. I want to pray for you today. Let us pray for an undefiled ear. That Jesus, He's critiquing us. He's saying, hey, what about this? What about that in our life? To have a New Year's resolution where we say, you know, God, it's okay for you to adjust some things in my life. To make things where they should be. You know, let the Holy Spirit illuminate His Word to you. But in order for Him to do that, you got to get into His Word. I just encourage you today, open up to Him and what He wants to do in you. Father, I just pray for those who today say, Lord, let my ears hear. Let me get into the Word. Let me spend time talking to You. Lord, I just pray You help us to do better. Lord, we recognize we've all failed. We've all missed the mark. And Lord, I thank You that You don't condemn us, but You convict us. You say, hey, this needs to change. And You love us in such a way that it does that. Lord, I just pray that You would do that in each person as they open up to You. They say, Lord, here I am. Touch my life. Make things right with You again. And Lord, You're so faithful to do that. Lord, today we just give You glory and honor. And thank You for ministering to us today. In Your name we pray. Amen. I'm so glad you joined with us today. I believe for God to do some great and amazing things in your life. I encourage you to come and join with us Sundays at 10 a.m., we would love for you to be a part of what we're doing here. May the Lord bless you and keep you. May you find His peace and strength every day.